aggressive, but he will constantly put out hitboxes, and he's going to force you to do something you don't like,
yeah.
And he's going to hit you for it.
Yeah, absolutely. He just wants you to become uncomfortable, and then he wants to play around how he conditioned you, and he just looks for the direct conditioning. So sometimes people go a little bit over his head, but when he really finds himself getting the reads, he's in a great spot. That being said, Dill puts him in the corner to start the set.
Yeah, you don't want to be here right now. Isn't really going to have to hold anything coming back to the stage, but once he gets on... You know what? Lucina gets off the ledge pretty well.
Yeah, absolutely.
Let's be honest.
And the scariest thing is she makes great use of gyro. If she wants to hold it, Z-drop nares and Z-drop fares are incredibly solid pressure, as well as Z-drop bears if she wants. She doesn't have to. That on top of just gyro confirms into fair and nair. She gets gyro, nair 1, F smash a certain
That sounds
pretty nasty.
No, I like Z-drop, gyro, nair 1.
Yeah, pretty nasty.
Yeah,
pretty
it definitely is. Okay, gets hit with that. Side B. Okay. E is really good at knowing when he has to use that early up B.
Ooh, that was a great read from him, too. Just aiming for the head so he'll get the hit anyways.
Did we see that gyro coverage?
Yeah.
He just took up the whole lane. You cannot merge to the ledge, though.
Yeah,
hold this fair.
You must wait.
Okay, possible death here.
Maybe mix up. Great mash coming on. Gets the counter as well. Yeah, that's fantastic.
I wonder why Dill opted for straight up air there.
Yeah.
That was weird. That's like not a part of the... Up tilt probably would have caught the counter.
Yeah, I believe up tilt would have caught him coming out of the ground, but I'm not 100% sure. Again, making use of the robo boost. E just not really accounting for the space he moves when he does it, but I think we'll catch on over time.
Yeah, sure.
Nice, nair spacing.
Oh, that was unfortunate.
He's going to get the downer on him. Yeah, there's no reason to re-grab versus Rob. Ever.
Was he trying to grab the gyro? Did he fall off stage for?
I think he might have hit down by mistake and just wanted to work around it, so he wasted some time.
Yeah, he had to realize what he just did to himself and then go, oh, shit.
He's like, all right, I guess we're here. And he's kind of just accepted it and is playing the stock out incredibly well right now.
Did you see Dill?
Looks for the counter.
Same situation, but isn't going to. That might have killed that down air from Rob. Rob's down air is chonk.
Yeah, that is a chonky move for sure. Nice backer from Lucina. That's, you want to talk chonky. Oh, tries to find the back hit up B. Ooh, that move's nasty.
It is.
Let's go, Eric.
I love
that
it
looking for it.
Dill just mashing down tilt on Eric.
Down tilt's so plus on hit.
It's crazy.
So
why does it do the things it does?
Yeah. He's getting like ticked, honestly. It's just.
That was so good. That pressure was some of the most insane pressure I've seen in this game.
Crouching LK, dude.
That's all it is.
Yeah.
And it like lock strings like into itself. You need to mash so hard.
Yeah,
you know what? Eric plays Lucina, so he actually does have the mash options.
Yeah, exactly. He's got the up B out of shield for the Abari. Quite nice.
But then you gotta guess, what if he holds you?
What
happened?
He pressed down. He had to press down, right? Tried to come off the ledge with the ball.
Because that wasn't a regrab.
Yeah. Definitely left ledge early.
Dill working his way to top three of a Xeno bracket, still in winners?
Absolutely. And honestly, I think Lucina is an incredibly strong pick for E here. So I want to see where they go in terms of map. What are you thinking?
I think Smashville is actually one of the best stage for the Fire Emblem characters in general.
Yeah, absolutely.
It is a little bit smaller, so you have less room to work around their sword. And the top platform allows them to evade people's pressure so well.
Yeah.
Like if you go to throw out a grounded button or just shoot a projectile, they just have this convenient bridge to just go above you, and then they're landing on you and you're scared.
Yeah, it's actually super terrifying. Yeah, totally agree. Honestly, they just make great use of the fact that they can swing at the platform too. Like, you really don't want to be trying to get on top of the platform on top of them. And you can't really play footsies with them. Scary situation. But
I'm surprised they wound up the PS2. This is definitely not the stage.
Probably comfort pick, E.
Yeah, but zoners really like the stage a lot. It's extra length. It's really nice just to stand underneath the platforms. You feel very safe.
Yeah.
Don't got to worry about Lucina landing on you with like up air or something.
She can't land on you with full hop, which is the biggest thing. Honestly.
Yeah.
You can just condition short hop and work around it from there.
And it's hard to short hop over Ross projectiles.
Honestly, yeah. You just get up angle lasered really hard.
Or he can bounce the laser for far enough away. Like he has.
Yeah, Rob is definitely
called it out right there, actually.
Yep. E with the good conditioning, for sure.
Yeah, look how well. Every time E gets in just like a little bit. Dill is right away. He nares, and he's like, other side of the stage. Let's do this again.
Yeah, yeah. I'm resetting neutral. Honestly, he's looking to reset neutral way, way more often than you see, because Dill will scramble with you.
He does. He gives him a little bit. He hits those eggs a little bit, a couple times around the bowl, but right away,
yeah,
after that, he's like, no.
Let's dance. Honestly, he's been outfootsing E in a lot of pretty crazy spots.
Yeah, but like I feel like every time he outfootsies him, he's not getting a neutral win.
Yeah.
He's just like, oh, I took back a little bit of stage control, which is very good, but you don't win, you don't take stocks by just getting a little bit more stage control.
Yeah.
Directly.
Yeah, yeah. Just gotta have to work a little bit harder than that.
Yeah.
They've both been finding some really nasty carries, but still gonna find that stock.
Think about how many buttons you just hit there on shield. You just like hit four in a row. And Dill just waited for the upbeat the whole time because he knew that.
Yeah.
That's such a
good
call. Honestly,
you just keep waiting. Pretty important for his Marcina. He should be putting a little bit more grabs there, but I think he's just playing this for the long con, you know?
Yeah, set it up with that last stock juice, you know?
Yeah,
game
absolutely.
Three juice.
Yeah, yeah. If he can find his way through this game without worrying about it and then he comes back, it's another pocket.
Well, we're far away from not worrying about it, especially when he's not even in the lead right now.
Yeah, absolutely. Great parry, gonna find the grab, put him back in the corner.
Marcina probably can't F smash that, right?
Yeah.
Nair is pretty safe.
Nair is pretty safe, but I believe F smash is
frame,
just quick
I think
enough
it's frame
that parry
10,
hard.
There's just frame 10. We looked at stuff the other night.
Parry on contact makes you plus 14.
Yeah,
so. Yeah. He can hard punish pretty much anything with Marcina F smash. I hope he notes that.
Oh, I was looking for the side view there, but good air dodge. Directional.
Doesn't get the meaty, but yeah. Honestly,
that was an anti-air.
That was great.
That was an anti-air. There was so much air between them.
Yeah. He was above the platform when he got caught.
I know, that's why.
Did he just boost with the laser, bro? That's nasty.
Boost.
That's nasty. Guess the timing mix like on parry, too, with this guy.
Oh, that's a big surviving right there. Is what I would say. You're
great
dead.
Fair. Yeah, he's been finding great corner pressure, honestly. It's been a lot of this game saving him.
His advantage. He's a madman at advantage. You know what you want to do against Rob when he's coming down? You want to swing at him.
Yeah.
You want to make sure he does not just float back.
He fast fell and he didn't find his button after gyro there. That was really unfortunate. And Dill's been taking a lot of mileage
that
off.
That fallout was so rough.
A little bit tilted, yeah. Finding some gyro play, though.
Especially
as
you approach Rob's throw kill percent mix-ups, you get so nervous against this guy.
It's incredibly nerve-wracking because you still have to play the projectile game.
You still have to worry because you'll get to a point if you just like totally avoid jabs, you get clipped out by... Went for it again, okay.
You're looking for the 2-0. That's a 2-0 move.
Yeah.
The robo boost back air from ledge.
Until just did like a roll in down till three times. Ooh, that gyro, can you not do that gyro? It's so nasty.
Yeah, that was...
Miss Tech, what did he read?
That's gonna be it. Hard reads, just hard reads the up B.
What did he go for? He was already in shield. Like, he didn't, like, just miss it. That was...
I'm not sure, man. Honestly, I couldn't
tell
you.
What was that?
What
was that up smash? What?
He just wanted to cover himself.
Covering
a lot
the roll in?
Yeah. Honestly, I totally understand where he's coming from because Dill is very... on point with his reactions. And once he notices you whiff something, he's going to punish you.
Yeah.
But a lot of that was run and shield. Pretty tricky coming from Dill because...
His inner smash 4 coming out.
Yeah. I mean, if E's going to press the buttons, run and shield is going to crush everything he's doing. And he found nasty parries on landing. He was finding really good shields just on get-up attacks. He found that really good shield on the up B. Found the second stock off the same exact thing. I don't know.